Good morning, Mr. Bruce back with the book of the day. Today's Monday book is Penguins Can't Fly. But before we start, eyes watching, ears listening, voice is quiet, body calm. Okay. Once there were two little penguin chicks. Their eggs had hatched on the same day, and they knew each other's names, Quentin and Billy. When they were baby chicks, they played together. They played peekaboo. They called each other silly names like Tintin and Chili Billy. As the young chicks grew up, their names changed. So did their games. Billy liked playing hide and seek, but it was a little bit rough for Quentin.
Ooh!
Quentin liked building with ice bricks, but it was too dull for Billy. He liked more action. They did make a den together once. The two little penguins were still quite different. Quentin liked knowing things like what all the fish were called and how many different types of snow there were, and best of all, how far away the stars were. Billy, he loved doing things like skating down steep slopes, hurling snowballs, and doing belly flops along the ice. In fact, Billy was always getting told off. He was always doing things mischievous. That means kind of wrong. Especially at school. You see, Billy just couldn't sit still. He tried to be good, but he always ended up being told off. "Sit still, Billy," his teacher said. "How are you ever going to look after an egg when you're older if you still can't learn to sit still?" One particular morning, Billy fidgeted so much that the teacher scolded him again. At lunchtime, Quentin couldn't find Billy, so he ate his lunch alone. He was looking at the clouds when some seagulls flew past. "Hello," said one gull. "What are you looking at?" "I'm looking at the clouds," said Quentin. "I think we're in for a snowstorm." "A snowstorm?" said the gull. "Yes," said Quentin, "it's not good weather for birds." "How would you know?" said the other gull. "You're not a bird." "I am a bird," he said. "I have feathers and a beak, and I am hatched from an egg." "Ah, yeah, but you can't fly, can you?" Before Quentin could think of a reply, the seagull swooped down from the angle and stole his lunch. Ugh. That night, Quentin couldn't sleep. He went to sit on his favorite rock and looked up at the sky. Through a tiny gap in the clouds, he could see some stars twinkling. "I'll never be able to reach you," he told the stars quietly, "because I'm a bird. I'm not a bird. If I am a bird, I'm a bird that can't fly." Then he heard the sound of a pebble being thrown into the water. "Who's there?" asked Quentin. "Oh, it's just me, Billy," he replied. "Oh, you couldn't sleep either?" "I'm going away," said Billy. "I'm fed up with being told off by the teacher." "I wouldn't do that if I were you," said Quentin. "I think we're in for a snowstorm." But there was no reply, because by then, Billy had already gone. Quentin was right. The next night, there was a terrible, terrible snowstorm. You could barely see your flipper in front of your eyes. Everyone huddled together for warmth, and the wind howled and the snow fell. Later, Quentin heard a voice calling, "Billy! Billy!" It was Billy's mom. "Have you seen Billy?" she said. No one could think of where he could be, except that is for Quentin. Quentin set off right away. It was dark, but Quentin found his way by looking at the stars. At last he came to the den that he and Billy had built when they were little chicks. "Billy, are you there?" he asked. "Yes," said Billy. He was shivering. He was so cold. "Your mom's worried about you," said Quentin. "Is she? Oh, okay, I'll come home then." The two friends walked home together. "You were right about the snowstorm," said Billy. And Quentin told Billy about the seagulls. "Of course we're birds," said Billy. "We just swim instead of fly." "I'm not sure I'll be able to swim," said Quentin. "Wait until we start swimming lessons," said Billy. "It's going to be great. We'll swim everywhere together." And Quentin didn't have to wait very long. That week at school, they practiced lining up, hopping, skimming, and twisting on the ice. Billy had a great time and didn't get into trouble once. In fact, the teacher said, "Well done, Billy." He said it several times. So, when it was time to take their first dive in the water, Quentin wasn't looking forward to it. "Don't worry," said Billy. "It'll be great." Billy leapt into the water, making a huge splash. Quentin stood at the edge of the rock and looked into the water. Just then, Billy shot back up out of the water. "Wow, Tintin," he said. "You're going to love amazing fish down here." "But I don't think I can," started Quentin. Just then, Billy shot back out of the water onto the ice. "Wow, Tintin," he said. "You won't believe the amazing fish and weird stuff that's down there." "Really?" asked Quentin. "Yes. I don't know any of their names," he said, "but you will." "Oh, I don't think I can," started Quentin. But it was too late. Billy took hold of his slipper and together they splashed into the water. And Quentin flew under the water and Billy was right. What an amazing sight. Look at all those different kinds of fish. The end. Okay, here's my question. The other seagulls said that they weren't birds because they couldn't fly. But it turns out that they can swim, which is flying underwater, and the other gulls couldn't. Can you think of something that you can do that maybe an animal can't do, like a cow or a dog or a mice or a cat? What can you do that somebody else can't do if they're not a person? Okay? So remember, until I see you tomorrow, be good and wash your hands. Bop, 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 bop.